Hey Pisces, it's me Stormie and here's your horoscope for November 2018. And Pisces, before we jump in and break this month down and see what's going on, the brand new blog is up, so make sure you hop over to stormiegrace.com and check it out. Or you can just click in the description box of this video or any of the November videos and you can get a link right on over to it, okay? So check it out. What's up there right now are the major astrological transits and aspects for November, December, January. I'm working on February. I'm getting there, you guys. And then it'll go through 2019. And I also put a brief description in each one of those blog posts on how to grab your chart and align it with those aspects so you can see where it's happening in your chart. And of course, if you don't have a chart yet, you can pick it up at stormiegrace.com or anywhere that you feel like picking up a chart. But make sure you have it. It makes those aspects a lot more exciting to read about, all right? All right, Pisces, so this month is a changeable month, and as a water sign, just kind of going with the flow and being that kind of changeable energy, I'm thinking you might just hustle and flow with it this month. We've got planets changing directions, changing signs, all of that. We've got the North Node of Destiny, which I am so freaking excited about, moving into a sister water sign of Cancer. So this is just gonna be not only a month, but the next 18 months with that North Node of Destiny that I think is very, very fulfilling. So don't worry, I'm making a whole separate North Node of Destiny and Cancer video, so you don't have to absorb all of that right now. But we've also got Jupiter, our planet of expansion and abundance of wisdom, moving out of Scorpio, where he's been for 13 months, and moving into the sign of Sagittarius, where he's home, he's comfortable, and he is ready to put in work. Whenever a transiting planet comes home to its ruling sign, it is putting in extra effort. It's like full beams, full benefit. And for you, this is going to light up that 10th house space. So this is great, because I feel like one of the things that has been kind of a theme for the Pisces energy over this last couple years is finding your feet and finding your voice at work, finding who you really are. Not that you couldn't get a job, not that you couldn't have a job, that's not what I'm saying, but you've really kind of been finding your own passion or your own expression in it. Like, even if you work for a company, how do you make this job yours? Or do you want to do this? Or are you ready to move towards that photography, that creative energy that you're willing to work with and work for? And even if you are a stay-at-home person, you're retired, whatever it is, I just feel like there's been a high amount of independence and creativity that's definitely be coming up for the Pisces energy. So this Jupiter expansion energy is going to be nothing but a whole bunch of help. All right, you guys, let's jump in and break this month down by date, okay? Right at the beginning of the month on the 6th, we've got that North Node of Destiny shifting out of the sign of Leo into the sign of Cancer. And remember, the North Node of Destiny always moves in retrograde, and it is retrograde because it's an inside job. So we're going to change some things here. This lights up your fifth house space. Now, the thing about the North Node of Destiny, you guys, is that wherever it goes, you will fulfill something here. You're going to look back 18 months from now and be like, oh, I did blah, blah, blah. And so what is it? It's in your fifth house. Did romance come to you? Did creativity, did your self-expression come to you? Did something happen with your children? Do you have children, right? What is it out of the joy, the hobby, the play, the pleasure that has come into your life, Pisces, in the next 18 months? Because you will have it. And that's the great thing, because where the North Node of Destiny goes, it's not interested in if you kind of want to have it. It's going to put you in positions over and over again where you've definitely experienced a little something. It's one of my favorite placements. Now, also on the same day, Uranus is going to retrograde back up into Aries. Now, this is going to light up the second house space for you. Here's the deal. Uranus has already been in Aries for 7 years. This is not new information. This is not a new experience for you. So for the last 7 years, you've probably seen your finances be a little unstable, up and down, or maybe you were learning things about finances. I think Pisces, definitely some lessons in the second house have to do with esteem and value, your value, how you value your services, how much money do you want to make? These kinds of questions have been on the table for a while now. Now, as we use this retrograde energy here, you're not having to go back over and do all of this again. Instead, you're looking for the bad habits or habits that need to still be broken down, find a new creative, innovative way to bring those to the table, and also looking back over the progress that you've made, right? Like you didn't work on something for 7 years for no reason. I sometimes have to look back to see how far I've come because I can get lost in the idea that I'm not doing enough, I'm not whatever, oh my God, am I still learning the same lesson? You know what I'm talking about? Look back because it will show you that you have made progress, okay? On the 7th, we've got a new moon happening in Scorpio, lighting up the 9th house space for you. The new moon is where we get new possibilities. Plant those seeds of intention for something new. Education, certification, religion, faith, travel, teaching, publishing, broadcasting. That means getting your YouTube channel up, getting that photography business going. That means getting yourself out in the public in some way. And it likely has to do with this value business, right? You can't have no successful money-making venture if you don't put your business out there. So this could very much so be a nice new ninth house energy for you. Could also be something just kind of seems foreign coming into your world that's actually very exciting. So keep me posted on that, okay? On the 8th, Jupiter moves into Sagittarius. He's coming home. We're lighting up and we're expanding you out into the world and we're expanding what you know and what your experience is in the 10th house space. So career, soul level calling, because it's not just about having a corporate business. You could be so retired, right? And this is about the skills, the gifts that you have to give to the world. Where are you at? What's happening here? You could have a status change. Maybe you're getting married. Maybe you're getting divorced. Any one of these things could be happening at the top of your chart, okay? Now, on the 15th, Mars is coming into your sign. And as you may know, hopefully you've had the opportunity to have an experience here. When Mars comes into your sign, you get a little boost, right? Like you get a little bump up, right? Mars is not particularly aggressive in your sign, though. Now, for everybody else, we're going to have to kind of slow down while Mars works with this Neptunian energy of yours. For you, you might be like, yes, motivation has caught me, right? So this gives you a little bit of bump of energy, of go, of aggressive, of assertive to push something forward. You've got all of these energies right now saying, get out there, get out there. So this is a beautiful energy to help you do that. All right, on the 16th, we've got a busy day. Venus is going to come direct in the sign of Libra, so in that 8th house space for you. Again, joint resources could be showing up for you, whether that's somebody investing in you, your partner getting money, and this could be a business partner as well, cooperations, collaborations, sponsorships, right? You can't get no sponsors if we don't know where you are. Things with sex and with intimacy and astrology, right? You've got a chance to move these things forward, but you're magnetic about it because Venus is here and she's like, yes, honey, yes, 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 pulling these opportunities to you, but not if you don't put yourself out there. I can't stress that enough, okay? Now, Mercury is also going retrograde on the same day in the sign of Sagittarius. So this is again in that 10th house space, and where this is gorgeous and we need to celebrate is that Jupiter is ready to expand you and Mercury says, I'm down, but I have to look around and make some decisions. I have to see what's here first. I have to review, re-edit, reconnect, rethink, revise. You have to go back over your 10th house space to see what's not working so that you know what to adjust so that you can do it coming forward. Mercury is observant and savvy. Use this retrograde, especially in your career, to see if you're in alignment with where you would like to be, okay? All right, on the 22nd, by the way, then the sun comes in there, so you're absolutely looking at your career life or your soul level calling status life this month, all right? On the 23rd, we've got a full moon happening in Gemini, so this is the fourth house space. The full moon says that something needs to be ended, acknowledged, or adjusted. You could be moving, you could be finishing a lease, or you could just be done living someplace. You could be making adjustments to your home space. You could be having conversations about your home space. The energy is in Gemini, right? You could be curious about moving even at this time where it's like, well, what would happen if I looked someplace else? So you could be beginning your search to live someplace else. You could also be having conversations about what is actually gonna make you secure. Whenever I'm looking over the career zone, the home zone is gonna get an evaluation as well. So you could be having this career and home conversation happening over this next couple weeks and seeing where that leads you. Whatever it is, it's about getting that inner security piece met so that you have a solid foundation, all right? At the end of the month, we've got Neptune coming out of retrograde in your sign. It's your ruling planet. It's like, ta-da, the lights are back on. And here's the thing about Neptune being retrograde, is that Neptune retrograde, you have the vision. Right? You see it, you can feel it. It's like, I can just feel it. I can taste it. I know I'm supposed to launch. It's in your sign. I know I'm supposed to go forward. I know I'm supposed to be doing something, but nothing feels concrete yet. So then when Neptune comes out of retrograde, the dream can be made a concrete, tangible reality, and you've got a solid foundation to move something forward. And it's usually creative, and it's innovative, it's compassionate, it is full of life and light, right? So you're gonna have something to share, and that something is gonna be you. It's something from this first house, whether it's you and how you're presenting yourself, a product, whatever it is in your external environment, you can now take the dream and make it a reality. And how great is that? I just spent a whole, 10 minutes telling you, get yourself out there. So now you can take you to be your own change agent to move something forward. That's an exciting month. I think so. All right, Pisces, like this video, comment, share, subscribe. Please keep me posted on what's happening in your month. I look forward to celebrating the victories and just being here together if something feels not so great as well, all right? I will see you guys in the next video. Bye.